My name is Patrick Leland. I got my musicians here with me today.
I am the Zach Monson. Welcome to another edition of Pause Play here at our very special venue, Canadian Music Week. And I'm with Canada's very own Patrick Lehman. How are you, my friend?
Good. How you doing, man?
Very, very good. We've known each other for a while, but this is the first time we've actually met, I think, in 4 years. So I'm happy to have you on the show, man.
It's been a strong Facebook friendship,
a
but
good
it's nice to
social
meet each
media
other in person.
Kinship. Yeah. What was music like in your house when you were a kid? You know, what was the music that was playing that your parents used to play?
A lot of vinyl records. There's a lot of 1960s, 70s, Motown, soul music, Stax, Atlantic Records, Stevie Wonder, Bill Withers, Marvin Gaye. But then we had like classic rock radio and Top 40 and that kind of stuff too. So, yeah.
And what was that music that you started liking as your own taste in music?
I'm going to have to go with Puff Daddy.
Oh, Puff Daddy. Puff Daddy, yeah, P. Like, Diddy, or Sean Combs? Which one are we talking about?
Puffy.
Puffy.
He prefers I call him Puffy.
Okay. Yeah. He prefers it. Yeah, you guys are close. Yeah.
Yeah, like 90s hip hop.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
When was the moment in your life that you went from being a music fan to knowing that music was the thing that you wanted to do with your life?
I don't think there was a time where it switched over. I mean, I've been singing since I was a really young kid. It was always something I sang in the church choir. We did stuff at school. I played music at home. So I don't think it was something I consciously did. I think became a teenager and just realized I didn't want to do anything else. So I took a vow of poverty.
Yeah,
and
okay.
I'm still abiding by that rule right now.
Yeah. Same leather jacket just every day. I like it. It looks good, though. It's fine. And if music was out of the picture, I mean, what would be your plan B? Scientist? Monkey trainer? Like, what are we talking about?
Monkey trainer? No, I don't know, dude. I have no idea. I've had a million jobs, so I know a little bit about everything, but a lot about nothing.
What was the worst job that you ever had?
It was not that long ago. Yeah. I was selling eyeglassware. Spectacles.
I have a sunglasses collection of over 300 pairs, my friend.
I've probably sold you some of them.
So we should have a little chat after the show, I think.
Yeah. Oh, no, I don't actually know anything about them. I was just selling them, so yeah.
Oh, I didn't want you to talk. I just want to talk about my sunglasses to you.
Okay, cool.
That's
we can do
I
that. We
to.
Can
okay,
do that.
That's fine. Yeah. The new album is Butchie's Son, dropping August 21st. So who is Butchie?
Butchie is my father. It was a nickname. He had the same name as his father and his grandfather. So in his family, everybody just called him Butchie. I think in the, I don't know, 60s and 70s, it was just like a nickname for Junior, sort of. But everybody always calls him Butchie. My mother called him Butchie. I mean, we didn't, obviously. But so, and he passed away pretty soon before the making of this album.
Okay.
So to me, it's just, the whole album is not about that, but I definitely thought it would be a bit strange if I didn't, you know, have a few songs about that experience. And so it's a way of honoring him, a little tribute to him.
It's nice.
Yeah.
The new single is Games, playing now on Stinger and Music. Great track. Tell me a bit about writing the song and what it's about.
Yeah, definitely the tune for the song when I wrote it, I could, you know, kind of, a lot of times I just hear it in my head and I just have to figure out how to produce that sound and try and make it as close to as possible what as I can hear for. But the song itself is kind of like a doo-wop R&B inspired pop tune, basically. And the topic is just about being, you know, being in love with someone and being with them for a little while, and you kind of get to that point where, you know, you don't want to mess around. I mean, you'll do anything for that person, but you don't want to play games.
Yeah.
So just cut the shit, basically.
And do you find that you find yourself writing about certain topics, you know, more than other topics?
At one point I was looking back at all the tunes I wrote, and I realized that a lot of them are a bit depressing. Yeah.
I find that's a lot of music, not
yeah,
just
a
you.
Lot of, yeah, a lot of music, a lot of good music I like too, is that way. But so I try to make a conscious effort to, especially a song like Games, that was kind of, if you just listen to the music of it, it sounds very upbeat and kind of happy. And
yeah.
But it's kind of tongue-in-cheek because the topic itself is, you know, about basically having troubles in a relationship and trying to keep it real with each other. So yeah. That was definitely on purpose.
Yeah. So we asked the last artist that we had in to ask you a question, and here it is.
Hi, my name is Laurent Bourque, and my question is, what is the last photo you took with your phone? And describe it and show it to us if you can.
Am I allowed to show that? I don't think I can show that.
You're not allowed to show me? What kind of a photo was the last photo you took?
No, we've been doing a little bit of press being here in Canadian Music Week, so it was probably a photo I took with my guitar player about an hour ago. We performed Games, a little version of that tune, so yeah, that's it. Nothing X-rated.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
That's too bad.
The picture before that one, though.
Yeah, I was really hoping this video would go viral really quick with that one, I'm telling you. That would have been good. If you could record a song with any artist in the world, who would it be and why?
I'll say Stevie Wonder. Oh. He's my number one.
That would be mine for sure. You're not the first artist that we've interviewed that has said that.
I would sing the ABCs with Stevie Wonder. I don't even care what I could sing with Stevie Wonder.
I would buy that for sure.
Yeah.
Do you have a favorite Stevie Wonder song? I'm a Sir Duke fan myself.
Yeah, that's a great tune.
That's a good one.
Love his music because it's varied. You have As and then Sir Duke is a totally different vibe. And
Do I Do? Come on.
Yeah.
That's a great little song. Do you have a lot of artists like to cover songs. Do you have a favorite song that you like to cover?
I've done Use Me by Bill Withers quite a bit.
Oh, nice.
That's a good one. I'm trying to think of what else. I love The Band. We've done The Weight by The Band. I try to do Aretha Franklin once in a while just to switch it up.
Yeah. What was the first and the last album that you purchased?
The first album that I purchased, the first CD I purchased was the soundtrack to a little movie called Rockadoodle.
Okay.
Anybody remember
Rockadoodle? Is that the one with the animated chicken who thinks he's Elvis?
That is the one.
It's a good film. It's just a good film.
It's probably on Netflix. You probably find it.
Yeah.
And then with the latest one?
The latest album.
The new D'Angelo album. Yeah.
That's some good stuff.
Yeah, that's good. I'm still getting into it, but...
Yeah.
Yeah.
As a Canadian artist, who are some other great Canadian artists that you're into right now that other people should try to listen to?
I've liked Huxley Workman for a really long time.
Yeah.
He's awesome. He's also very, very varied. I like Lights. I love Joni Mitchell. I mean, a lot of older stuff, a lot of newer stuff, too. Yeah.
Yeah.
I really like an artist named Ariane Moffat.
Amazing.
She's great.
Yeah,
I think
yeah.
She's new record just came out.
Absolutely. Yeah. Good stuff. You can hear Patrick Lehman on Stingray Music's Canadian Indie Channel, Canadiana Channel, and Soul R&B Channel. Thank you so much for coming by,
Thank you for having me, man.
Are you going to play some music for us?
We will.
Amazing. Tune in next time, guys.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for watching. Click on the left to subscribe to Pause Play. Click on the right to watch more videos.